Welcome back to Steve Robb Reviews. Today's review is going to be all about how to actually get your solar panel ready for install, what it all takes, and some tips on exactly things you should think about before you even get started, the materials that you use, and I'm going to show you how I install it. Now, on my particular place that I'm going to install it, it's like a peak roof like this, and I'm installing it on the outside edge. And there's some tips I'm going to share with you, especially if you live in a climate like I do where there's lots of snow. I'm going to talk about the different angles that you should have on your solar panel, what's ideal, what's not ideal, what works for me, and what may work for you. So let's get started. Okay, let's start off with the materials. This here is 1.5 inch angle aluminum 1/8 wall. I had 2 8-foot sections, and I've got 59 5/8 left, so you're going to need about 11 feet for this. I got this all cut up already. I'll show you, this goes together. You're going to need a, well, if you want a 45 degree angle, well, one of these works great, or you can use a protractor and set yours up for whatever angle you want. But generally between 30 degrees and 60 degrees depending on what you're trying to accomplish, but generally for me, two angles, 30, 45. Now up at my camp, I've got a 400 watt solar array. I split the difference and went about 35 degrees, 37 degrees on my panel. And there's a reason for that. And this is the hardware that I'm going to be using right here. These are all stainless steel except this clip here. I got 4 1/4 inch wood screws. And these are quite beefy, and they're treated for outdoor use. Silicone caulking, which I won't be using today. And I got a way of fastening these in. So let's go over to the panel and let's take a look at that first. Well, this is the back side of the panel, and almost all solar panels, this is a 100 watt solar panel, they all are gonna come configured something like this. There will be some punched out holes that goes all the way around, and you can utilize these holes. And before I even get started, T for top, B for bottom, and I had to drill, doesn't want to focus there. I had to drill one hole right here to match this for 1/4 inch. And this is where I'm going to mount everything here. So I put a 2 there, and you'll see why, and I put a 1 right there. And you can see on the leads here, I identified the leads because this here says positive, the other one says negative, and after about a month, that thing will blow off. So I always just put an identifier on here, just some red tape, and I put a zip tie just to hold the tape on. And then I go over here, yeah, positive and negative. So I have to identify that as well, because you never know for future use, right? So this is the panel right here. And it's nothing special. And the most you're going to get out of this panel, I believe, is about 5 amps an hour charge to your battery system. So I'm going to slowly put this together for you and explain exactly the thought process. But first of all, what is the reason why I put top and bottom? Well, you're going to need to orientate this the proper way. And you can very easily get mixed up between your top and your bottom and your angles and everything else if you don't have it all figured out ahead of time. So I've learned over the years, mark everything first, that way there, when you go up to install it, it takes like maybe a 30 minutes tops, and it goes smoothly. And that's the whole idea behind this video, is to make things smoother for you so you could actually do something like this, because a lot of people are not too sure exactly, what do you do when you get a panel, now what? So I'm going to show you exactly what the now what looks like. Okay, so every solar panel that you're going to buy, the dimensions might change from different one manufacturer to the other. But this one here is 45.5 by 21 1/8. So I like to use stainless steel. Everything stainless steel with a stainless steel nylon lock nut there, but you can use just a regular nut and everything galvanized if you like. or not. I mean, come on, it lasts a long time regardless, but I like to use the stainless because I have it. Now, if you just take a look at that right there, all it was two cuts. And that's pretty simple. You just make two cuts. And the only thing I did was, as you could see right in the corners here, is I rounded off the edges, and you'll see the reason why that in the future. But it's just regularly two cuts, just from one side over to the other, and you just match up the holes that are already inside the panel itself and fasten it down, and that's it. Now, the holes that you see here, well, they come as you build it, and it's so easy to put together depending on the angle. Like, I'm picking 45 degrees because I have quite a bit of a snow load at my place. So if I have it tilted at a 45, well, the snow doesn't stay on there, and a little bit of sunlight hits the top of the panel and the snow will all fall off. Now, if I have it at a pitch lower, you know, well then, you know, you can see how the snow is going to sit there a lot more than if you have a pitch like this. So actually 30 degrees is pretty good, depending on where you are. I'm in the far north, and 30 to 45 works fine. Now, the best ideal thing is if you have like one of these sun trackers where your solar panel is going to rotate with the direction of the sun and everything else. But guess what? Most people don't have that. Neither do I. And so far, all the setups that I've installed, well, they work fine just as a fixed unit. And this is a fixed unit going to go on an asphalt shingled roof. And let's get to the next part. Okay, so let's take a look at this right now. All I did was put in the fasteners loosely right here, right here, and right here. And as you could see, if you take a look at the angle square there, that's all I used. I just clamped it to the bottom here, put the rail up. And if you're wondering, like, how long do you know you should make everything? Well, you can pretty much see that it goes like this. And after you do this the first time, even if you were to make the base here a little bit longer, it's okay. But all you have is these cuts. They're so simple. I mean, everything is 45 degrees, so you can cut everything at 45. This one is a 90 and a 45 here. Now, you notice that I went a little ways extended. You have to go at least, well, for me, about an inch and a half out further than your panel. And that's to raise it off the ground, well, off the roof, a bit, so you have some space at the bottom of your panel. You don't want to mount it where the bottom of the panel is touching your roof. And also, it lets the airflow go through it as well. You don't want to have like a big sail up there, right? So you want to have as much airflow around the panel as possible. And all I have to do is tighten all these fasteners up. And you'll notice that I put one hole here, and I put one hole here, and they're 16 inch on center. And I'm gonna mount it on the roof and put the screws in this way, and then I'll show you what I do in some installations when like I'm doing this by myself. So a lot of times people are worried about, well, the screw's not gonna hold. I've never had no problem with using the screws so far, but if you got in a really high wind area, yeah, you want to bolt it down, and that's another alternative. You could use bolts as well. And now the aluminum itself, I think, is a good choice. It doesn't rust. I don't recommend using steel, because you know what? It's going to get quite heavy by the time you actually have to install this and lift it up on there. Now, you could go with steel. You could go with wood. You can go with all kinds of stuff, just that this is how I do it. And I'll tell you something. The price of aluminum today, you want to make sure you get your cuts right. And you can just see how the first one went in there, then the second one with a little bit of an overhang, and you just cut everything like this at a 45 and bring it up to it's about the end of your panel here. And the vertical piece, so I mean, it's three pieces. It's not too hard to figure out, right? Now, you can buy some of these units already pre-made, but I guarantee you the vast majority of them will not work for, you know, most situations. You got to make it custom. So this is about as easy of a custom mount as you can possibly figure out. So let me tighten this up, and then I'll bring you back with everything all fixed. Okay, so she's all tightened up now. Everything is all fastened tight. And I just want you to imagine that this is the edge of the roof line right here. So you could see if there's snow on it, it's not going to come down and hit the roof. It's going to fall right off. And that's the ideal thing that you want to have, is so that, you know, the rainwater, everything can, you know, it's not going to pool up. And, you know, when the snow comes down, it's going to go right off the roof. So you don't want to have it back set. And I'll just show you here. You could see there's the space there, which is plenty of space, right? All the way along. And that's what you want right there. Now you can adjust your measurements, you know, to whatever suits you. And then you could see here, well, I've got one hole right here. Now you can see where there's lots of room to put a power tool in here. Because what I do is I always get a drill. I put it where I want. Then I get a drill, same size as this, quarter inch. And I only drill into the asphalt. And, you know, the shingles. One here and one there. And then, same on the other side. Then I move the panel over. You can see where the holes are. And that's where I put a nice big blob of RTV or black silicone caulking, whatever color the roof is you have. Doesn't really matter. It's going to be hidden by this. Then I slide it back over top. Then I can put the fasteners down through the deck on the roof, right? And I just want to show you the back side here. So I installed the clip. I put in a couple more zip ties here. And what you're left is these male and female MC4 connectors. Now, I used to buy the connectors years ago with a pigtail wire on them and everything. I don't do that anymore. What I do is I buy the connectors in bulk, very cheap, and I make my own. And so that's it pretty much right there. And it's so easy to do if you just take your time. And now, of course, I have a portable bandsaw. But, you know, I've done this with a hacksaw years ago. And the most it took me was about an hour and a half of just taking my time making the cuts. And it's as easy as that. Okay, so let's take a look at these blocks that I have. These are just some PVC molding. And what I did is I ran the fastener through once, and you could see like they're all pre-threaded in there. And all I do is when I'm just take the fastener, goes in through your plywood deck, and you're going to have about this much or more depending on how long your fastener is. So I figure I've come about this far. Now, I'll probably use a 2-inch, not these 1-inch, but I just grab them for reference. And then you can grab these. What I do is I put some construction adhesive on the outside and some in the hole. And then from the bottom side, I just screw them in. So that is like a giant block or a washer on the bottom that holds it really firm. And they work terrific. I mean, just as simple as this. And if you want, you know, you don't need a wrench for this or anything. You just tighten it up, and then you have the construction adhesive on top, you know, like some PL Premium. Just let it set. Man, you will never be able to pull that solar panel off the roof if you tried, you know. But, you know, that's just extra insurance, right? So there's a little idea for you as well. And you have to make sure that what's showing through has to, like from your top side, has to at least come to here, right? It's no use if it's sitting here like this. It's got to come all the way through. And that's the whole idea behind these blocks.
Well, thanks for joining me here today. And if you have any questions, feel free to ask. If I have the answer, I'll do my best. But in the next video, hopefully, what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how I wire up them, the connectors, the MC4 connectors. I have a special tool for doing that. So for me, it's worth my time to invest in the tool and the connectors. And then I'm going to show you how that crimping tool works. And then we're going to go up to Northern Ontario, and I'm going to show you the panel installed and the wiring that's involved that I do to connect it. And I'm going to show you how easy it is to operate a solar panel install. And, you know, everything is so easy to work with. today there's so many great videos that show you any particular part that you're interested in. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how you actually have your wire go through your roof and over to your charge controller. It's a very simple connection, and I think most people can do it. But, you know, like everything else, if you're not shown at least once, well, it can be quite a daunting task if you just don't know. So it's great, you know, to have some information. YouTube is a great resource for seeing some things that maybe you never thought about, you know, and how other people do things. You know, I don't criticize other people on their installs, because if it works for them and it suits their needs, well, that's just terrific, because they got out there and they did it. And, you know, you can hire somebody to do everything you want in your life, but it's great to actually do something yourself. So thanks for joining me here today. Come back again. If you haven't seen this channel before, you're welcome to subscribe. And hopefully next time, we're going to be up in Northern Ontario again. Cheers.